you have many years ago, back in fourth grade, seen some of this. But I have a couple of things I want to add to the program. I want to warn you that I'm going to make some things very, very cold. So especially you folks sitting in the front, if something rolls off the stage and lands in front of you, don't pick it up. Okay? It will give you frostbite in a matter of seconds. The stuff I'm going to use is liquid nitrogen. Very cold. We've got spilled aluminum on the stage right now, so we can see what it looks like. Celsius is the scale that's used in most of the rest of the world, international units, or 77 degrees Kelvin. Most scientists would say that liquid nitrogen was 77 degrees Kelvin. Next one. Three numbers, same temperature. You guys remember this, but let's see if the grown-ups can do this, okay? How far is it between my fingers? About. Just a minute. I want the grown-ups.
And foot.
Okay. About a foot, right? How far is that in inches? Well, can you go on to the next one? Next one. Next one. See how I said go real quick? Okay, in inches, how far?
12.
I'm here.
12 inches.
12 inches, okay, good. Now, 7 inches.
Okay, who knows centimeters?
I listen to an adult.
That's
30.
Yeah. Did you have somebody help you? Oh! Okay. I can't look both directions. Okay. Okay, now in yards. How far is it in yards back there? Are you science
people? A third.
4.33.
About a third. 0.33. Good. And now in miles. How far is it in miles?
What is that distance in miles? 5,000.
Good, thank you. I've had adults that couldn't answer that question. Okay, next slide. Let's do some science. You want to see some of this stuff and what it can do? And most of all, you want the end of the program, right? Because at the end of the program, we are going to make something you will enjoy. We're going to put some things in the liquid nitrogen. I have a couple of ping pong balls. Some things to put in there. Bigger and bigger. I've got a couple other things to set up. Would you believe, you can see how little the liquid level has gone down? Started out. Those currents will make a magnetic field themselves. that will repel the field of this magnet. Repel it exactly. So, got to start cooling, and then let's see, probably better if my fingers aren't directly in the fluid. I've got to put it on that a little bit. Now, you folks up here in front where you can see it, it'll take a little bit. We'll let them tell us something happened, and then we'll bring it to where the rest of them can see it. Okay? Move back. It takes a little bit for that to cool down. While it's doing that, let's look at some of these things that I've put in the little bag here. Of course, I explained the banana is so hot that it made that boil. You might have noticed that I'm a little bit, I don't have the things all together that I need. I forgot a hammer. Some of you know what I'm looking for, right? I want to drive a nail into this board. Can anyone make a suggestion what I use to drive the nail?
Hammer.
Use a hammer. Does that seem reasonable? Drive a nail with a banana? Let's see. Now, this is another place where things might come off the stage. If they do, don't touch them. Okay. Let's see if this works. Gentlemen, is that the way you drive nails?
Yes.
Use it all the time, right? Great. Great. So, the banana has changed its properties a lot. I can break the banana. That sounds kind of strange, but break the banana. And if I do, you can see that the inside, the very inside, it didn't freeze yet. It wasn't cold enough to freeze the very inside. But the rest of it has been frozen. Biologists use this technique of freezing something so they can slice through it to make very thin sections. Anybody work in a hospital and have frozen sections? That's what they're talking about. They're talking about freezing cells and slicing through it so they look at it in the microscope.
Have you heated that back up again?
Yes.
We
often do that. It will take too long. Well, maybe after we've had the, and maybe at the end of the day we'll be able to, end of the program, we'll be able to have something.
Hold the dinner.
What?
Hold the dinner.
Did you hold it?
No.
If you only held on to that part, yes. If you held on to that,
you can't hold.
No. So no, you can't. I don't want you getting cross-eyed.
There's something liquid nitrogen is used for that maybe these guys up here in the corner have used for. Have you ever used liquid nitrogen to drill a tunnel under a river?
Never been one under a river.
Okay. Well, what they do is pipe liquid nitrogen into the soil under the river, and as it's frozen, they can hollow it out, and then they get the concrete forms poured in there while it's still frozen, so that the river doesn't collapse down into the tunnel.
The superconducting magnet is now floating over there. It's entirely above the surface. There is nothing between it holding it up. It's being supported by its own magnetic field. Nancy will come back in science to show you. While I'm doing that, let's check out that marshmallow. Check out the marshmallow. Marshmallow. Now, who verified this was a good marshmallow? Somebody over here. Check out a good marshmallow. what you expect a good marshmallow would be. You expect a good marshmallow to be. Oh!
Oh my.
I seem to have made a mess. I broke the marshmallow. And it's still a marshmallow. It still tastes like a marshmallow. Okay,